Hi everyone. In this video, I will show you how I embed bilingual subtitles into my YouTube videos, just like the one I show in this video. Adding subtitles could be tedious and time-consuming, but it will help bring in more audience. If you are a teacher, adding bilingual subtitles to your lesson videos will definitely benefit many students and educators. To save time and add subtitles for free, I rely on getting subtitle files with the speech recognition technology from YouTube. Trust me, you don't want to type your subtitles manually. That would be super painful. So after editing my video, I first upload a video file to YouTube privately. To upload a video on YouTube, click the create icon on top. Select the video type you want to upload and click open. I usually skip entering most details because I will delete this video after I obtain the subtitle file. To make sure you have a high chance of getting the automatic subtitle, you want to open the More Options section and set the video language to the language you speak in your video. After that, click Next and move on to Visibility, then make your video private. After you hit Save, YouTube will start processing your video. I usually wait till it shows finished processing, then close the window. So you will now see your newest private video in YouTube Studio. When you check it in the subtitles section, you will see that it shows one language, which is the video language you've selected, and it shows Add on the right side. That means no subtitle has been added to your video yet. So I usually just go to do other things, wait for 1 to 2 hours, and come back to check if the automatic subtitle is generated. After it's generated, you should see the word automatic after the video language you've selected. Let's say you wait for one whole day and still don't see any changes. There could be a few reasons. One reason could be your video language is not available for automatic captioning. So far, automatic captions are only available in English, Dutch, French, German, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Portuguese, Russian, and Spanish. If your video is too long, has poor sound quality, or there's a long period of silence at the beginning of your video, YouTube also won't be able to generate automatic captions. If automatic captioning doesn't work, an alternative way is to use Google Translate. On Google Translate, set the language on the left window the same as your video language. Then click the microphone icon to record your video audio. Now, when you play your video at the same time, Google will recognize your speech and transcribe the text for you. Copy the text in Google Translate. Then go back to the subtitles section on YouTube. Next to your private video, click the down arrow button. Then click Add. You will see an option to transcribe and auto-sync. Hit that button and paste the text. Then click Set Timings. It takes a while to auto-sync your text to the video. You can check the progress by clicking the Refresh button. Once it's done setting timings, you will be able to enter the edit page. If you are able to get the automatic captions, you can just click the three dots next to the Publish Automatic Subtitle and edit it. I like to edit my subtitle on the YouTube Studio first because it's easier to navigate. Click Edit and play the video as you edit the subtitle. The video will pause when you click one of the text boxes. My suggestion is to break down the sentences by hitting the Enter key so that each phrase or sentence fits the video in one line. When you break down the sentences, you will notice some phrases don't line up with your audio. You can adjust the timing by dragging and sliding each box under the video. Notice the sound waves show you when you stop talking in the video. So I just continue to edit each line until I'm satisfied with the result. After I finish editing the subtitle, I just save and publish it. Then return to YouTube Studio. This time, I'm going to open the published video language subtitle, which is the one I just edited and saved. You should be able to download the subtitle there. But I usually like to go to the edit page again and just to make sure the edited subtitle is saved properly. Then I will click Actions and download my subtitle file in SRT format. I will then change the file name immediately and add the language to the title. The next part of this video is to show you how to quickly get a translated subtitle file in a second language. I use a website called Subtitles Translator. Once you're on the website, scroll down to upload the SRT file you just downloaded from YouTube. Click Next and select the second language you want to translate. I don't want to edit the subtitle on this website, so I just click Cancel to get my file. You should see a download button and get a zip file. Again, I want to rename this subtitle file and add the second language to my title right after unzipping it. The last part of this video is to show you how I embed the bilingual subtitles in my video. To achieve this, I use a software called ArcTime. ArcTime is a free software created by a few Chinese software developers and it provides English UI language. However, they don't have an English website. But don't worry, I will walk you through the installation process on both MacBook and PC. The page link to download this software is shared in my video description. For Mac users, click the middle button to download the Mac version. After getting the zip file, double-click to unzip it, then open the folder. I'm sharing the translated version of their introduction file in this video if you need it. To add the software to your MacBook, open the Applications folder in Finder and drag the ArcTime Pro application to that folder. When you first try to open the application, the system will say it cannot be opened because the developer cannot be verified. Just hit Cancel and go to System Preferences, then click Security and Privacy. In the General tab, you should see a message saying ArcTime Pro was blocked from use because it is not from an identified developer. Click Open anyway, then click Open again. This time, you should be able to open and see the applications with English UI language on your desktop. Now for PC users, click the first button on the download page to get the Windows version. Choose either 64-bit or 32-bit, depending on the PC you are using. To unzip or extract a WinRAR file, download a free software called 7-Zip. After installing 7-Zip, right-click on the ArcTime zip file. Move your cursor to 7-Zip and select Extract Files. After choosing the file location, you will then get the extracted folder in that location. Once you are in the folder, double-click to open the ArcTime Pro application. Finally, it's time to embed the subtitles to a video. To import your video, click File on the top menu. Select your video and open. The next step is to import the subtitles. Notice there are three eye symbols on the bottom left. Each eye symbol represents one row of subtitles. We will use the top two rows. Double-click the first row to select it. It should appear brighter than the other rows. Click File on the top menu, then open the second language SRT subtitle file. Click Continue, and you will see this subtitle file is being imported to Group 1. Just click OK. The next step is very important and will make sure the subtitles don't overlap. Select the second row next to the second eye symbol by double-clicking that row, and click File on the top menu. Then open the first language SRT subtitle file. This time, import the subtitle to Group 2. Right after this, go to the Groups setting on the right side and change Group 2 to Default L2 category. Note that you can create your own categories to save your favorite font and style, but you don't need to worry about that now. To edit the font styles of each group, click the A symbol. First, I want to edit my Chinese subtitle file, so I open the category it belongs to, which is Default. In there, I could change the font style, size, outline, shadow, color, and many other things. I usually check to display the safety box so I can position my subtitles better. To move your sentences vertically, just slide the vertical margin. If you usually present tutorial with a white background, I would recommend to check the rectangular border. Checking it will add a rectangular gray layer behind the subtitle. The same procedure applies to editing the Group 2 subtitle. Move it vertically to make sure it doesn't overlap with the Group 1 subtitle. You can play around with the style setting until you are satisfied. Now that I've finished setting my font styles, I just go to the beginning of the video, then proofread and edit my second language subtitle. To edit a specific line, double-click that subtitle block, type in the text, and hit the Enter key. You can also change the timing of each block by sliding and dragging it, just like what you would do on the YouTube Studio. After editing my Chinese subtitle, I usually watch my video one more time to make sure everything looks fine. At this point, you probably feel kind of exhausted from all the editing. But you know what? We can finally export a video with the bilingual subtitles. Click Export on the top menu and select Quick Video Compression. If you don't want to wait for a long time to compress the video, just use their recommended setting and hit Start Transcoding. If you want to make sure your video has high resolution, I recommend to set the CRF to 16 and set the preset to 8. If you choose any number lower than 16 and higher than 8, it won't make a big difference, and it will make the transcoding process extremely slow. After the video is done compressing, a folder will pop up and you will see your video with embedded subtitles in there. Since I worked so hard to edit the timing and translation of the subtitles, I always make sure to save them for future use. To first save my Chinese subtitle, I click the eye symbol next to the English subtitle to hide it. Then I click Export on the top menu and select Subtitle File. You can pick your subtitle format. I usually just save the SRT file. Next, I hide my Chinese subtitle and turn on the eye symbol next to the English subtitle. Then repeat the same process to save it. For my YouTube videos, I usually upload the English subtitle file so that my viewers can choose to enlarge the font size if they don't want to see the Chinese subtitle. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you find this tutorial useful. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Until next time!